Often going in a game menu and turning all the settings up and calling it a day may result like this.
Ultra settings.
Turning all the settings to low is an easy option to get back the performance. But do you really want to play like that on your expensive, powerful machine? This is Noah Monkey, and I'm gonna show you how to make your game from this to this without losing much performance and visual settings much higher than consoles, and bang for your buck. So sit back, I'll show you the settings and explain it to you. It's not a new thing that developers optimize their games for the consoles due to their restrictive components, but we can take advantage of that. GTA 5's console quality settings are already out there, and we can start from there. If you don't have a NASA computer, don't worry, most of you rocking a GTX 1060 or a RX 580 now. If you don't own a graphics card, stop watching this video. Or if you have a minimum GTX 1050 or a older card, don't worry, I'll tell you which settings you have to turn down. FXA is minimal in cost and effectively remove jagged edges from a scene, but I would recommend 2x MSAA with TXAA turned on. Using FXA can drastically improve the jagged edges, but it tends to make the image more blurrier. But Rockstar has implemented its own FXAA and it makes the game look much nicer. If you have a 1060 or a RX 580, I would recommend you should try the MSAA option. Coming up next, population density and variety is more reliant on CPU than GPU. But if you have a weak CPU, turning down those settings helps. Consoles use around 80% of population density and 50% of variety. Modern CPU and GPU should use 100%. For a older CPU, stick to the console settings. Distance scaling is evenly used by CPU and GPU, but already optimized. Feel free to use 100% as console set to 100%. Normal shadow quality looks like this rough edges, but consoles uses high quality shadows. You can see in the background menu, the shadow looks much nicer now. Setting it to very high from high crunches the GPU performance. Very high makes very unrealistic sharp shadow, so I recommend you try high. Next setting is reflection quality. Console setting is mixed in this case, as all global reflection is set to high or very high. Only mirrors are set to ultra quality, but PC doesn't have individual settings, so we will set it as ultra. Weaker cards aim for high or very high. Reflection MSAA doesn't justify the visual gain, so turn it off. Console quality is off too. Difference between water settings is minimal to naked eye, but higher setting you go, more precise displacement and water complexity increases. For balance settings, I would recommend high. It will be sufficient. GTA 5 uses stencil shadows. Stencil shadows are sharp and unrealistic. Using Umbra technique, it makes them soft or more natural. It is cost effective and easier for the GPU and CPU calculation. AMD CHS and NVIDIA PCSS is less effective on cascading shading, resulting very broken shadows around. My recommendation is use softer, as it makes the visual best. Post effect settings difference between normal and high is stark, as normal strip off most of the bloom and lens flare effects. Difference between high and ultra is negligible, and I can tell the difference. Only next settings, the depth of field quality can be tied to this. Only GPU memory is needed for textures. There is no performance penalty. 4GB cards or more slap that very high settings, and lower cards use high or normal instead. Now, the shader quality only affects the depths on the ground. It's actually parallax occlusion mapping, and older technique used in early 2000s. Modern GPU can handle this with ease. Use very high or high. Coming to grass quality, the normal quality cull all the vegetation from the scene. Whereas difference between high, very high and ultra is interesting. High to very high increase the draw distance of vegetation and the visible range of shadows underneath. Ultra in other hand increase the draw distance furthermore with extra density of grass. Only Xbox One use custom high settings and other consoles use mix of high and very high. We'll stick to very high for the balance between visual and performance. GTA 5 uses standard SSAO. We are gonna use high as consoles are set to high settings. Tessellation is pretty much not noticeable above high, and there is no performance penalty. So, should be set to high at minimum. Depth of field is self-explanatory and use it by your taste. Anisotropic filtering is cheap nowadays. As modern GPUs use faster bus lanes, it's irrelevant. Only consoles struggle due to their custom CPU and GPU controller. But for PC, there is no reason to not use 16x or 8x minimum, as there is maximum of 0.01% performance hit. Only integrated graphics or cheap graphics cards can produce trouble. Before showing you the advanced settings to use, I just want to share that I am starting a new series named Do You Really Need? From this episode. And there will be more games I will discuss and dissect the graphics settings. So if you wanna stick around, feel free to subscribe the channel, it helps. And one more thing, share your thoughts and share with your friends. As you can see, I have turned on these three settings. Long shadows make dusk or evening shadows more stretched or real. High resolution shadow make some indoor shadow and some object shadows resolution higher and some distant shadows too. High detail streaming is the ground object popping. Whenever you fly above the ground in jets, it reduces that poppins. Coming to extended distance scaling, is higher than what you have been said before. It makes the draw distance further more way long in the distance. But be warned, it costs heavy CPU and GPU usage. If you have GTX 1070 or higher, turn on these settings. GTX 1080 or high can use 100%, but 1070 or 1660, I would recommend you should use 50%. And 1060 or lower, make sure you turn off this setting. Now, the last setting I'm gonna talk about, it's funny, as you can't access it. Only accessible if you turn on very high shadows. Remember, I told you to stick to high as very high will crunch your performance. So, if you still want to have this, don't worry. I got you covered. Extended shadow covered the distant map with full baked shadows, as you can imagine, making the game photorealistic. But are these settings needed? Why game developers add these heavy settings anyway, if our PC can't handle this properly? Well, just think for a moment. 5 or 10 years ago, maybe you played San Andreas on your older PC or laptop, and frustrated about the graphics settings you couldn't turn on. But today, on your rig, you can throw whatever settings it has without thinking about it or wondering why these graphics looked amazing 10 years ago, but not now. Well, you have your answer. To make game visuals future-proof down the line for 10 or more years, they put these advanced settings. That's it for now. If you have watched till the end, I hope you liked it. And if it is, show me by clicking the like button. Stay frosty. Bye.